Thank you. So that spares me about talking about myself. That's the good part. So welcome. Today's theme of our speech is going to be Georgian-German Year 2017, Facts, Challenges, and Prospects. And joining me in this discussion will be Mr. David Vashadze. He's head of experts and distribution at the Georgia National Film Center. And he will be talking about film and the film industry and our participation at this year's Berlinale. Yes, I'm the cultural attaché at the embassy, as Radostina mentioned. I've been working as a cultural attaché since 2014. Thank you. So the main challenge for a small country, of course, is to promote the culture and to tell the German people possibly a lot about Georgian culture, because we have a very very rich culture, and this is the only way to attract tourism and to attract attention towards a very small country in a region which I'm sure not all of you have visited. I will try to make a little introduction to why 2017 was declared to the Georgian-German friendship, let's call it friendship year. Of course, the focus is on culture, but it also involves politics and economic relationships and, of course, science, educational programs, but the main focus will be on culture. 2014, Georgia signed an agreement with the EU about a twinning project, and this was the first twinning project for culture that was implemented in Georgia, and I will read you a little bit about what it meant. It was development of Georgian National Museum as an institution, and the main goal of this 27-month project was to strengthen the Georgian National Museum as an institution, which is enabled, which was enabled to speed up culture as an essential component by the development of Georgia. Besides the resident twinning advisor who was sent by the National Museums in Berlin for the period of the project to Tbilisi from German side, there were more than 40 employees involved in consultations, mostly taking place in Georgia. The focus of the project relied on the following topics: planning of the museum buildings, storages and workshops, improvement of preventive conservation practices, and the introduction of common museum standards. Visits of German experts with their experience and expertise in form of consultations, working group sessions, and seminars to Georgia. Moreover, study visits and internships at the institutions of the National Museums in Berlin served for further education of the Georgian colleagues. Through the scope of this twinning project, a unique possibility arose in the collaboration between two cultural facilities of national importance. So the ties between the Georgian National Museum and the cultural, the Prussian Cultural Foundation, which is based in Berlin, became stronger. And this resulted in a month or weeks of Georgian culture at the Museum of European Cultures in Berlin, Dahlem. I don't know if you've been there, but it's a wonderful museum. Which hosted Georgian culture for about a month. We had lectures, panel discussions about educational issues, about politics, involving students. We had exhibitions about Georgian wine, which is wonderful, by the way. I'm sorry, I don't have a sample on me. And we had also wine tastings, we had concerts, we had exhibitions of young Georgian artists, and book presentations. And it became so popular by the beginning of the month, there were very few people because nobody really knows a lot about Georgia, but at the end of the month, the whole Berlin was talking about it and everybody was coming, and the hall was packed and we didn't know where to place the guests, and it became really popular. We had very good press. So as a result of this, the next step was that there was an official act following the celebration of Independence Day, of the Georgian Independence Day at the Bode Museum in Berlin, where Georgia hosted, for many years after World War II, Georgia also hosted about 100,000 prey books that were taken from Germany. And the decision was made that they should be brought back to Germany, and the symbolic handing over took place at the Bode Museum when Mr. Steinmeier, then the foreign minister of Germany, received two books from Prime Minister of Georgia as a gesture of intent. Steps and measures have been taken since, and we're still moving in the direction of bringing the books back to Germany as a gesture of friendship. 2015, there was a very big festival in Berlin, Young Euro Classics Festival at the Konzerthaus in Berlin, which hosted a Georgian youth orchestra. It was a very big celebration of Georgian culture. The hall was packed. We had very good press. And as a result, we had another big concert this year at the big hall of the Berlin Philharmonic on January 7th, which I will be talking about later. 2015, the decision was made between the two foreign ministries that the Georgian, that 2017 would be announced as a Georgian-German year, it's called. So we've been working hard since, and the official start or the opening of the year will be April 28th, 2017. Why April? Because it also coincides with 25 year anniversary of the Georgian-German diplomatic relationship. So there are a few important aspects, and I will just try to list all of them. So we have the issue of cultural heritage. The National Agency for Cultural Heritage Preservation of Georgia, together with German partner, Association for the Preservation of German Cultural Heritage in the Southern Caucasus, launched the large-scale project of inventory of German cultural heritage monuments in Georgia in 2015. I forgot to mention, we decided to have 2017 as a friendship year because of a few reasons. I already mentioned the 25 years of diplomatic relationships, but it's also 200 years of German settlement in Georgia. 200 years ago, German so-called Pietists, this was a religious group of Germans who believed that they should move to Jerusalem, asked the then, Georgia used to be part of the Russian Empire, so they asked the Tsar about the permission to settle in Georgia because they thought that it was a beautiful land and it was perfect for wine making, and they were they came from Schwaben, a part which is famous for wine, and they wanted to settle there, and we still have wonderful German settlements. So it's the 200th anniversary, so that's why we decided. The results of the projects are now available online. And 25 German monuments in Georgia were already granted the status of cultural heritage monument, though the process will continue, and other German monuments will be granted the cultural heritage monument status as well. The addition of a special album is planned where the historical materials and the current condition of the German cultural heritage monuments will be presented. By the way, if you're still around and interested, on Monday, February 20th, the Humboldt University is hosting an exhibition about German settlements in Georgia with historic photographs and very interesting material. Three monuments of the German cultural heritage, probably two monuments in Bolnisi, which is a Lutheran church, will be selected for the rehabilitation works. Also, the infrastructure of the village will be rehabilitated. The project will be financed by the government of Georgia. the issue of the legal status and function of the Lutheran church after its rehabilitation was raised, and that's also an issue that we're working on. The rehabilitation projects will be implemented with active involvement of the German experts. The possibility of restoration of historical cheese factories as a German cultural heritage in this region was discussed. For implementation of this initiative, it is important to attract investors. We're still working on that. Cooperation in the sphere of museums. The new museum will be opened there in the German settlements. The Georgian National Museum, together with the local institutions and German partner organizations, work on the project of the museum, and construction works will start soon. The museum educational programs will be developed. The Georgian National Museum has a good experience of successful cooperation with Goethe Institute in the frameworks of educational program Deutsch Lernen im Museum, learning German in a museum, with the aim to support learning of German language in Georgia. For 2017, for this year, the Goethe Institute in Tbilisi and the Georgian National Museum developed new programs tailored for the new museum. We're talking about the new open air museum possibility as well. Education and science. Germany is one of the most important partners of Georgia in the field of higher education. Number of events are planned to be organized in 2017 with participation of Georgian and German higher education institutions. Among them are holding the Georgian-German Conference on Education to mark Wilhelm von Humboldt's 250th birthday, organized by Ministry of Education and Science of Georgia with participation of Georgian and German higher education institutions, organizing a conference of German-Georgian historical, cultural, and educational relations organized by the Ministry of Education of Georgia, organizing German Science Day in the framework of International Science Fest, establishing European departments at Georgian regional higher education institutions, holding a performance in Georgian and German languages by the pupils of Deutsche Internationale Schule in Tbilisi, the capital of Georgia, intensified deployment of Kulturweit volunteers and trainee teachers. We've had very good experience with native English native speakers who came to Georgia and taught English to high school kids all over the country. So we're trying to implement the same for German speaking native speakers. Informational Center of the German Academic Exchange Service, DAAD, in Tbilisi will undergo consultations with its headquarters to implement various educational programs during 2017, conferences, summer schools, summer language courses, and workshops on German language and literature in universities, etc. The celebration of German Language Month in Georgia, with the participation of the German, Austrian, and Swiss embassies to Georgia, could be used as a pillar event in terms of German language popularization. The importance of involvement of the Georgians who received education in German universities in the celebration events is very important. And I think if you look at the cabinet of our ministers, like 2/3 of them probably received their education in Germany. It's planned to have 9 resource centers across the country of Deutsche Volkshochschulen, and they can be used for different occasions. The discussed was also the possibility of opening a contemporary art center in the area of German settlements. We're working very closely with the German sites in the field of literature, as 2018, Georgia will be the guest of honor at the very prestigious and famous International Book Fair in Frankfurt. And this is a very, very big deal for the Georgian literature, which is ancient, but also the contemporary literary work is very interesting. So we've been working towards this since 2014, and in October 2018 we will be guest of honor, and this will be the last and the most important part of the friendship year. So it goes beyond 2017, and we have a few activities planned for 2018 as well. We do this closely with the participation of Georgian National Book Center. The 7th Literary Forum and Dialogue for Publishers, Translators, and Literary Agents will be organized. 15 to 20 German publishers will be invited for the forum, and special professional program will be elaborated. 3 seminars for the translators from Georgia to German have been organized. There's a special literary tour for journalists who work in the field of literature. And 2017, there will be a ceremony of passing of the guest of honor country status from France to Georgia in the frameworks of the Frankfurt Book Fair. There will be a literary festival with participation of Georgian and German authors. In the field of sports, UEFA European Under-19 Championship is planned to be held in Georgia in 2017. The participation of the German team is, of course, welcomed. The importance of cooperation in the field of sports medicine is an issue, and we're working very strongly with our German partners. We are organizing summer camps for young sportsmen, where they will be taught in German language. Let's talk a little bit about arts. The other form of art, such as music and theater, is very important. I will give you a detailed information about the 2017 activities in the fields of art and music a little bit later. All these events are planned considering the influence of social economical condition of the society, and the concept or the common program of the Georgian-German Year is of friendship supports to achieve the one main goal, people-to-people connections, and to boost the tourism to Georgia and the Georgian tourism, of course, and the interest to German language in Georgia. I talked about this, and I would like to talk a little bit about the association agreement between Georgia and the EU, which doesn't say a lot about the culture, but a little bit. I can talk about the cooperation in the cultural field. The parties will promote the implementation of the 2005 UNESCO Convention on the Protection and Promotion of the Diversity of Cultural Expressions, cooperate on the development of an inclusive cultural policy in Georgia, and on the preservation and valorization of cultural and national heritage with a view to fostering socioeconomic development, promote the participation of Georgian cultural actors in cultural cooperation programs, including Creative Europe. Do you know what Creative Europe is? I don't have to talk about it. The cooperation in audiovisual and media field, the parties will cooperate to prepare for an implementation of EU mentioned in relevant annexes and of the agreement, and support Georgia in work towards reinforcement of independence and professionalism of the media in compliance with relevant European standards and approximation of the audiovisual legislation with the EU acquis and by the association agreement. By exchanging of views on audiovisual policy, relevant international standards, including cooperation in the fight against racism and xenophobia, the exchange of best practices and, regarding freedom of the media, media pluralism, decriminalization of defamation, protection of journalist sources, and cultural diversity aspects of media through regular dialogue. strengthening the capacity and independence of regulatory authorities, bodies for media, cooperation in research, technological development, and innovation. The parties will cooperate in facilitating the integration of Georgia into the European research area, enhancing Georgian participation in the Horizon 2020 program, reinforcing human, material, and institutional resources in order to improve research and innovation capacities, reinforcing Georgian participation in Marie Sklodowska-Curie actions. The parties will cooperate in the overall modernization and reform of Georgia's education, training, and youth systems, in particular by carrying out joint work and exchanges with a view to promoting Georgia's further integration into the European higher education area in the context of its membership of the Bologna process, including through fostering the independence and autonomy of Georgian universities, promoting academic cooperation, capacity building, and student and staff mobility through the new Erasmus Plus program and researchers' mobility and training Marie Sklodowska-Curie actions, encouraging a strategic approach to vocational education and training with a view to bringing Georgia's VET system in line with the modernization of EU VET structures as pursued in the Copenhagen process and through its instruments, encouraging a strategic approach to youth policy and enhancing exchanges and cooperation in the field of non-formal education for young people and young workers as a means to promote intercultural dialogue and support civil society, inter alia, through EU programs in the field of youth. We have also been working on a cultural agreement between Georgia and Germany. In 2017, we're hoping, because the text is being finalized by both parties, but for the opening in April, Georgia and the governments of Georgia and Germany will be able to sign the agreement concerning cultural cooperation. It's in the fields of cultural exchange, promotion of culture and language skills, cooperations in the field of education, academic exchange, film and the media, young people, people-to-people connections, sports, conversation of monuments, return and conservation of cultural property, persons living in the territory of the other contracting party, non-governmental organizations, regional and local level, cultural institutions and experts, cultural consultations, and so on and so forth. So this is going to be held in April. I hope then we will have a much broader exchange in all these fields with Germany and other European countries as well. So we are already in 2017, and although the official part of the Georgian-German year is starting in April, we have a few activities and kickoff events that we have hosted and we're planning to host, and I would love to tell you a little bit about those. On January 7th, I already mentioned the Great Hall of the Berlin Philharmonic, we had a concert of Georgian and German music, and this was a kickoff event where we announced that the year is taking place with participation of the ministries, the foreign ministries of Georgia and Germany. We had an orchestra from Georgia, and we had two choir ensembles from Georgia, a boys' choir and a men's choir with polyphonic Georgian chanting. It was a huge success. I was one of the soloists at the piano. It was different. And we had on January 26th, we had Georgian wine tasting at one of the larger hotels in Berlin, and a talk with the ambassador of Georgia, which was organized by Business and Diplomacy magazine in Berlin. We are presented lavishly this year at this year's Bilateralism. And my colleague or my friend David Vashadze will be speaking in detail about our participation at the Berlinale. On February 2nd, our ambassador held a lecture about Georgia and the Georgia's regaining of the independence in 1918 at the Christian Albrecht University in Kiel. Georgia was part of the Berlin Green Week, which is hosting agricultural events or companies from all over the world. You know, we presented our wine and food industry. On February, in March, you know that the Daniel Barenboim Zeid Academy has been opened in Berlin, and they have a wonderful new concert hall, Pierre Boulez Hall, and a very famous violinist from Georgia, Liza Batiashvili, is going to be one of the first musicians worldwide to perform in this hall. We're looking forward to this concert, and she will be performing together with Pierre Boulez Ensemble. Georgia will be participating in this year's ITB, which is International Tourism Fair in Berlin. The National Tourism Agency is preparing a wide program. On March 17th, a young Georgian artist, Vajiko Chachriani is his name, is going to be presenting his solo show exhibition in Berlin at a very prestigious Daniel Mazzona gallery. In March, end of March, Georgia will be participating at this year's Pro Vine conference and fair, obviously we will be presenting our wine. On March 22nd, Ambassador of Georgia will be speaking in Düsseldorf at the political organization We Are Europe. He will be speaking about Georgia's European way. Georgia will be participating at the Leipzig Book Fair in end of March, and we have a very wide literary program there with presentations, discussions, actors participating, and so on and so forth. In Cologne, we will be part of Lit Cologne with a few writers from Georgia. In Frankfurt, the Literaturhaus Frankfurt will be hosting a few Georgian writers for book presentations. In March, we have also planned a visit of young Georgian business managers who will be coming to the Federal Ministry of Economy and Energy for an advanced training program. A Georgian dance company, Georgian Royal National Ballet, will be giving a tour throughout Germany, and on April 4th, they will be giving a big concert at Berlin's Admiralspalast. You know that there is a new wonderful concert hall in Hamburg, the Elbphilharmonie, which is booked, and you cannot even get one ticket for standing for the next few months. And a Georgian artist, a Georgian pianist, Khatia Buniatishvili, is going to be performing there on April 5th. Georgia will be participating in April as well at the Investment Management Exhibition 2017. On April 28th, we're working on the opening of Georgian-German Year, as I mentioned. We will have an ensemble, an opera ensemble from Georgia to give a concert on this occasion, and we will be presenting an exhibition of German-German Archive of the Common Heritage, and the exhibition themes will be involving German colonists, diplomatic relationships, architecture, Germans in Georgia, vice versa, supported by German Federal Ministry in collaboration with Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Georgia and the Culture Ministry and the Embassy, of course. On May 8th, we will hold an investment roadshow, a forum, Georgia Investor Day, with the participation of the Prime Minister of Georgia in Frankfurt. We have planned quarter-yearly lectures of German scientists working about themes related to Georgia in the fields of archaeology, history, physics, and so on. And this will be held at the German Center of Archaeology. We are also planning quarter-yearly lectures and talks at German universities with participation of Ambassador of Georgia. He will be talking about Georgia's European way. The embassy will be holding panel discussions with German experts. This will be related to political themes. In Bremen, we are planning an exhibition about 50 women from Georgia. These are historic figures who have been very important to the development of Georgian civil society or arts throughout, you know, the 19th and 20th century, because these are the women whose photographs we have. And this project was very successful in other countries, and it will be the first one for Germany. It was developed together with Heinrich Böll Foundation. In April, we also have Georgian drama theater at the Schaubühne in Berlin. In Wiesbaden, we are planning Georgian films at, I think they will be participating this year as well at the festival Go East. In May, we have a big event at the new museum in Berlin. It will be a presentation of a new catalog, a very large book about Georgian archaeology, and followed by a reception and a concert. Then we have a Georgian theater week, up to 10 contemporary Georgian performances and different stages in Berlin. In May, we have a business forum in Hamburg, another concert of a jazz pianist from Georgia at the Pierre Boulez Hall. On May 26th, we are celebrating the National Independence Day in Berlin, and we will have another dance company and a singing ensemble of 10 singers from Georgia. We have a very wide-ranged cultural program planned in Freiburg at Künstler Tribüne, with the support of Freiburg Municipality. On July 1st in Berlin at Villa Elisabeth, we'll have a night of Georgian culture with DJs and exhibitions and classical concert part, readings and CD presentations. And then I don't know if you're familiar with jazz music, but it's a very famous jazz musician, Nils Landgren, who will be giving a concert with Georgian young jazz musicians at the annual Young Euro Classics Festival in Berlin. We will have a Georgian DJs night in Berlin at several clubs in September. October, November, we have a two-month Georgian film retrospective planned with the Film Institute Arsenal. There will be a lot of exhibitions of contemporary Georgian artists. Of course, the Frankfurt Book Fair, and I mentioned already the importance of that. Georgia will be participating in October at the Anuga, the world's leading food fair for the retail trade and the food service and catering market in Cologne. In October, Berlin is famous for its Festival of Lights, so we will be, we hope that we're still working on it, but we hope that we will be participating and introducing Georgia as a tourist destination at different landmarks of Berlin. A lot of Georgian opera singers will be presented at different opera theaters throughout Germany. Yeah, this is the main events. Of course, the smaller ones will evolve with time also, and we are working and creating the website for the Georgian-German Year, and we have a Facebook site, so if you will be interested, you can see and follow all our events. What we're trying to achieve by this, it shouldn't end with a wonderful series of events and see Georgian-German Year was wonderful. No, it should be a boost, and it should be a starting of something deeper. And I think that's what cultural diplomacy is for. I think that's what we as diplomats are here for, and we only get a limited time. It's about 3 plus 1 year, and this is the time that we get to introduce our country to Germany. And this is the work that I've done, and this is what we're trying to achieve is more attention towards our country, more people-to-people connections, and more tourists from Germany, not only from Germany, but from all over the world. And I think we're doing a pretty good job. So thank you for your attention.